Buhari is set to leave seat as president, obeying NLC's order. Commuters were on Wednesday stranded as the Ogun State chapter of the Nigerian Labour Congress NLC, as well as residents of Sangota, took to the street to protest the poor condition of road in the area. The protesters gave federal government and Ogun State government a 21-day ultimatum to fix the Lagos-Abeokuta highway or leave the state. They also threatened to shut down the entire state by leading a mass protest should the government fail to fix the road at the expiration of the 21 days ultimatum. Members of the NLC and those of OTA Progressive Youth Initiative thronged the highway, expressing their grievances over the poor conditions of the road. Armed with placards bearing inscriptions like "Repair our road with immediate effect or face the wrath of the masses. Our roads are death traps. Fix our roads. No good roads. No payment of tax. Industries in Otta are relocating and closing down due to bad roads." Among others, they shut down highway from Joju bus stop, leaving dozens of road users stranded. The protesters, the second in recent times, is coming in spite of assurance from the Minister of Works and Housing, Babatunde Fashola, and Governor Dapo Abiodun that construction works would soon commence on the road. Speaking, the chairman of Ogun NLC, Bankole Emmanuel, lamented that in spite of Governor Abiodun and Fashola on the spot assessment visit to the road, nothing had been done. Bankole said a few weeks back, the governor and the minister were here telling us that they will commence the reconstruction of the road. We are surprised that since when they came, not even a single tipper of gravel has been put on the road. Serious. This implies that they can't do anything. They are just fooling us. They don't have any plan for us. At this juncture, we need to withdraw our destiny from them. Bankole lambasted politicians, saying they don't have any good plan for us. The NLC boss recalled that people voted for the All Progressive Congress, both at national and state level, for peace to reign in the nation, regretting that unfortunately it continues getting worse day by day. If they want to defend themselves, they will start saying one is federal government road and other is state government road. Did they tell us this before the election? We give them 21 days ultimatum to start working on it, or else we'll shut down the whole of Ogun State while everyone sits at home, since they are not ready for us. And we'll make sure that they all leave the seat because we place them there. Enough of this system of fooling. They know how to go to nooks and crannies during campaigns, but when roads are bad, they wouldn't go there. Last time, they were saying they were not aware that the roads are bad as this. Since when they were aware, what have they done positively? We need them to know our minds. If we keep quiet, they wouldn't do anything. And that is why I am calling on all citizens to let's arise and face this struggle. Bankole submitted.
Oh my God. It's my dear viewers, this is how will I put it? Is it reality or dream come true or what? See, our leaders, those in power, are people that you cannot know their minds. And you will never know their minds. Never. You will never know their minds because they have always been this kind of people. Misleaders, liars, cheaters, and destroyers of destiny. There are people who will come to your doorstep when it is time for campaign. They will knock. They will knock. They will knock. Why? Because they need your support. If it means coming to you morning, afternoon, night, and making your home their home just to achieve this, they will do that. Can you imagine? They are not trusted beings. They are not people we should put hope on in any way. They don't deserve it. Well, it is so and quite unfortunate that Ogun State is realizing this, but I will say it's too late. Yes, that's what I will say. More than late, when they supposed to lament, they didn't lament because of the little cake that the ones that is very close to the governors are getting. Because of the little cake they are getting. You think that they will listen to you? They will not. They will never listen. That is human beings for you. Do you understand? That's human beings for you. That's why I said it earlier then during election, that's a gubernatorial election. I said it that look, be careful. Be careful, politicians are like the devil. This is the time that they will come to you with empty promises, presenting it to you, lying to you, telling you, giving you empty promises that look, they are going to do this, they are going to do that. Please, don't listen to them. I told you, don't listen to them. I told everyone that don't listen to them. They are deceivers. I want everyone as seriously not to listen to them. You see that? I want Obaseki came. He said all he wants to say. His opponent in the PDP also came, said what he wants to say. They made all the promises they want to make. In fact, I really appreciate the election in Edo that very time because Edo people really did what my mind really wanted. I'm telling you the truth. They did what my mind wants. They voted with their conscience. They were not carried away by the big geese and big guys in the state. You need to see Tinubu now. You need to see Tinubu. You need to see Zamfara state governor. Yeah, you need to see big politicians, Fashola and all of that. You know, believing that with them they can influence the people to vote for APC. You understand? But to their surprise, the people looked down on them and voted who they really pleased to vote for. You understand? My dear viewers, that is what is called deceit to the finish. You understand? Deceit to the finish. So please, I want us to see into this matter. To see into this matter and try to know the truth in this? What truth can you derive from what has just been pointed out? Because from what the Ogu people have just made out right now, it means that they are trying to make us to understand that they have been abandoned. Yeah, that's what they're trying to say. And I would like to concur with them, because that is the reality. That is the attitude of our leaders. Okay. Let's hear you anyway to know what you equally have to say. Don't forget to leave your comments below the comment section. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.